we've collected some of the finest talents from the Walter classroom of our school. And with the time, equipment, and of course money that we've been rationing, we hope to put together a pleasing and entertaining show. I was hoping that your hostess, Ms. Helen Yee, would fill you in on some of the treats in store for you tonight, but I can't seem to find them. Well, no rush, I'll have to go on myself. Colin, what are you doing? Don't you think before we go on, we should explain to the audience what Phantasmagoria means?
Oh, yeah, it says right here. Phantasmagoria is a fireball of wonderful events thrown together in a fantastic order.
Helen, what's wrong with you? Please forgive Helen, ladies and gentlemen, but do you know what you're saying?
Okay, Steve, you asked for it. It's not about women's lives, it's great. It's all about magic, magic to do.
Thank you. to sing a rock-a-bye baby?
I'm sorry, sir, but I wasn't listening.
Well, the rest of the audience is listening.
Why?
As I was saying, ladies and gentlemen.
What's going on behind that curtain?
Any song at all, please.
What's going on behind that curtain?
There's nothing going on behind this curtain.
There must be. There's nothing going on in front of it.
Important to you, but it's yours to me. So give me a break, huh?
I really want to sing, Dalton.
Yes, I want to sing.
Then sing, Dalton, sing. I like to see somebody try and stop you.
Thanks, friend. And this time, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to sing.
And this time, I'm going to
play.
Listen to me, little mouse. I've been asked by my cousin to stand godfather to a little one she's brought into the world. He's brown, with white spots, and they want to have the christening today. So let me go to it, won't you?
Let go by all means. And when you are feasting on all the wonderful things, think of me. I should so like a drop of sweet red wine.
But there was not a word of truth in all of this. The cat had no cousin and had not been asked to stand godfather. He went to the church, straight up to the little pot, and licked the fat off the top. Then he took a walk over the roofs of the town, saw his acquaintances, stretched himself in the sun, and licked his whiskers as often as he thought of the little pot of fat. And then...
Is it common in your family?
Oh, what does it matter? It's not any worse than crumb pickle like your godchild.
A little time after this, the cat was again seized with a longing for the pot of fat.
Again, I must ask you to do me a favor and keep house alone for a day. I've been asked a second time to stand godfather. The little one's black, with the white ring around its neck, so I cannot well refuse.
So the kind little mouse consented, and the cat crept along by the town wall until he reached the church, where he went straight to the little pot of fat and ate half of it.
Nothing tastes so well as what one keeps to himself,
he said, feeling quite content with his day's work. When he reached home, the mouse asked everyone to run in at him.
Cat gone.
Cat gone? What a strange day! I bet it must be found in the cat.
Soon after, the cat's mouth began to water again for the
mouse. Again, I must ask you to do your favor. But my cousin again had another child. Black, with white feet, and not a single white hair on its body. Such a thing does not happen every day. So let me go to it, won't you?
Top off, half gone. I never heard of anything like it. Ever can it be?
So the little mouse cleaned up the house and set it all in order. Meanwhile, the greedy cat went and made an end of the little.
There, now all is finished and one's mind will be made easy.
He said, and came home in the evening quite sleek and comfortable. The mouse asked at once the name had been given to the third child.
All gone.
All gone? What a strange name! I never heard of anything like it. Whatever can it be?
And shaking her head, she curled herself around and went to sleep. After that, the cat was not again asked to stand godfather. And made an end of her. And that is the way of the world.
Thank you.
deal. Let's listen.
About my three fish. shoes. Do I have Hugh Greek guessing here? I have M.G. Robinson. Well, I'm pretty good. Now, let me ask your favorite drunk, W.C.P.
On my way here, somebody asked me to wave to my high school. Said, could you come with you boys? That's a sickie, so am I. I'm saying human body is 75% water. My case is alcohol. Now, I want you to remember that no daffodil ever won a war by dying for his country. He won it by making the other poor dumb daffodil die for his country. Now, all this stuff you've heard about America, not want to fight, want to stay out of war, want to poop. All right, bunch of petunias. You know how I feel. All right, the man you've been waiting for, Richard Nixon, yeah, that's his name. All right, let me bring him out. Let me say, I am the president. Here come now. Get it, of course, I'm joking. Let me say, I love America. Always heard the point. I'm working. Me and Pat love Dom. Let me just say, I'm just like marriage. I mean bullish on marriage. I said bullish. Let me make that perfectly clear. I said bullish. Oh, Henry, get me out of this one. Oh. And in cold, let me say, I am not a cold. I am not. I'm just a damn good liar.
Really good show. Let me tell you about the man I have on your next week of great accents. I have a man from the Bronx Zoo, four-speaker monkey. When the monkey can't make it, Richard Nixon's coming back. Also, I have a few aerial photographs of Kate Smith, which I know you really enjoy. Also, I have...
Now, I want you to remember that no bastard ever won a war by dying for his country. He won it by making the other poor, dumb bastard die for his country. Now, all this stuff you heard about America not wanting to fight, we'll stay out of war, it's a lot of horse dung. Americans traditionally love to fight. All real Americans love sting the battle. When you were kids, you all admired the champion marble shooter, fastest runner, big league ball player, the toughest boxer. Americans love a winner and will not tolerate a loser. Americans play to win all the time. I wouldn't give a hoot in hell for a man who lost and laughed. That's why Americans have never lost and will never lose a war. Because the very thought of losing is hateful to Americans. The army is a team. Lives, eats, sleeps, fights as a team. The drought, he stalls a bunch of crap. The biggest bastard who wrote that stuff about him drought, eh? For the Saturday Evening Post. Didn't know any more about a real battle than he did about Fonica. Now we have the finest food and equipment, the best spirit, and the best men in the world. You know, by God, I actually pity those poor bastards we're going up against. By God, I do. We're not just going to shoot the bastards. We're going to cut out their living guts and use them to grease the treads on our tanks. We're going to murder those lousy Hun bastards by the bushel. Now, I know some of you boys are wondering whether or not you'll chicken out on fire. Don't worry about it. I can assure you, you will all do your duty. The Nazis are the enemy. Wade into them. Spill their blood. Shoot them in the belly. When you put your hand into a bunch of goo, and a moment before was your best friend's face, you'll know what to do. Now there's another thing I remember. I don't want to hear anything about holding our positions. We're not holding anything. Let the Hun do that. We are advancing constantly, and we're not interested in holding on to anything except the enemy. We're going to hold on to him by the nose, and we're going to kick him in the ass. We're going to kick the hell out of him all the time, and we're going to go through him like crap through a goose. Now, there's one thing you men will be able to say when you get back home, and you may thank God for it. 30 years from now, when you're sitting around your fireside with your grandson on your knee, and he asks you, what did you do in the great World War II? You won't have to say, well, I shoveled shit in Louisiana. All right, you sons of bitches, you know how I feel. Oh, I will be proud to lead you wonderful guys to battle anytime, anywhere. That's all.
Thank you.
You have a picture?
Yes.
You got a single that's a very good picture.
Absolutely.
All right, tell me who's the picture.
Who's on first?
I'm not asking you who's on first. That's not the picture's name.
All right.
But
last time, who is not pitching? Who?
I'll break your arm, you say who's on first. What's the second? What's the pitcher's name?
What's on second?
I don't know.
Third base.
You have a catcher?
Yes.
St. Louis has a very good catcher.
Absolutely.
The catcher's name?
Today.
Yes, today.
Not yesterday, today.
Yes, today.
Not yesterday, today.
Yes, today.
Not yesterday, today.
When today?
Now today.
Hey, go ahead, tell me.
Today.
Yes, today.
Not yesterday, today.
When today?
Now today.
Go ahead and tell me.
Today.
Yes, today.
Not yesterday, today.
Forget it. Forget the whole thing. I'm a good catcher, you know.
I know that.
I'm a very good catcher. I would like to catch for your team.
Well, I can make arrangements.
You're my friend. You can make arrangements. Now, me being a good catcher, the guy up is going to punt the ball, right? So, me being a good catcher, I got to throw that guy out of first base. So, I pick up the ball and throw it to who?
Now, it's the first thing you said, right?
I don't even know what I'm talking about.
Well, that's all you have to do.
Is to throw it to first base.
Naturally.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
Who's got it?
Naturally.
Naturally. All right. I picked up the ball and I thought you naturally.
No, you throw to first base.
And who gets it?
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying.
All right.
I picked up the ball and throw it to first base.
And who gets it?
Naturally.
Naturally.
All right. That's what I'm saying. All right. I picked up the ball and throw it naturally.
Yeah. No, you throw to first base.
And who gets it?
Naturally.
That's what I'm saying.
I can't say that.
That's the way I'm saying.
Okay.
All right. Another guy gets up and hits a long fly ball to be caught. Why? I don't know. He's on third and I don't care.
Oh, what'd you say?
I said, I don't care.
Oh, that's our shortstop.
Come
gentlemen, here they are, the Andrew brothers, or sisters.
Thank you.
Miss Amy Irons.
Less rules and red tape. How hard is it to play a dog?
We see this as another role in Unravel.
Thank you, Mr. Freedom.
That's an inside joke.
I'm Benedict Arnold. I trade.
Do you want to say anything?
Come on, Helen, say something.
It was a lot of fun, and we had a really good time, and we had a really good cast, and we had a really good senior play.
Cast party following the S.O. Night production at the Dumont.
I thought it was very good, and
that's the way of the world.
And that's the way of the world. Okay.
Hey, come on, who's on first?
I don't know anything about it.
You don't know anything.
No.
All right, you were one of the dancers.
Yeah.
The innkeeper. Here we are again, back at the swinging party at Price.
One, two, three.
For the innkeeper.
Your last bottle. They'll have to go on water.
And here she comes. Here she comes. Secondhand Rose. Hey, Charlie, what's the story?
Well, we had a really good time.
And we loved it.
Yeah,
we really loved it.
Yeah, we're really good pals, and this light's killing me.
Smile, you're on camera.
That's it. I got my hands
open. Of course, there's two of us leading ladies from the play tonight.
Funny crashes. I just can't get out. Go away. It's me, all right?
Hi.
A swinging party again, folks. Back again at Bright's cast party, the night of the 40th annual SO. And it's your roving reporter, Jack Buck, signing off.